All righty, time now to turn back to meteorologist Brittany Beggs and the Storm Alert Center. And Brittany, I am looking out my window. The sun is shining and I stepped outside. It feels really good right now. So as we approach fall.
Yeah, so we're just a couple of days away, and it's certainly feeling like that locally. The clouds have kind of cleared out for some of us, and those to our east, you're still going to have showers ongoing for the next couple of hours. To our west, it's going to be a pretty nice day for you all. I want to real quick just talk about Hurricane Teddy. This is the next storm that we are watching. This guy is still about 1,000 miles from Bermuda, but it is a major hurricane already. National Hurricane Center says this is a Cat 3 now. Max sustained winds are about 120 miles per hour. Those tropical force winds extend outwards over 200 miles. So the track of this, it's moving northwest slowly. It's expected to strengthen tonight to a Category 4. By the time this reaches Bermuda, it could still be a major hurricane. Now, the newer forecast track, it is showing the eye, or the center of it, as a Cat 2 east of Bermuda by Monday and Tuesday of next week. So this is the newest info that we have. Remember, Bermuda was hit just last week. So this is the next storm system we'll be watching. It's a major hurricane at this point, but it is not expected impact our nation here, which is some good news. But there is another little low we're watching over the Gulf. So remember, can't put our guard down. It's still that time of year. Locally, let's get to our forecast. Low dew points are going to be arriving tomorrow. As Latrice mentioned, it already feels rather comfortable out there. Most of us are still in the 70s at this hour. As we move through tomorrow, it'll feel even more comfortable, and this will be the trend. It'll inch that way each day this weekend, and next week gets even nicer. So we've got a really comfortable weekend upcoming up. Remember yesterday, I've added in a small rain chance for Sunday. I went ahead and I removed that again because the forecast models are showing not much to trigger anything this weekend. In fact, starting on Saturday night, nighttime lows are going to drop to the 50s. And it looks like that starts Saturday night, continues Sunday, Monday, and into Tuesday night of next week. That means those folks that are on the higher elevations, you've got 40s coming to you starting up on Sunday morning. So really nice, tranquil weather ahead. High res radar right now, where we still have some very light rain ongoing across Cherokee County. That's about it. It's kind of already broken up over Gilmer County and over Fannin County. So overall, I think if you've got plans to be outside today, for most of us, keep those plans. Overall, if you're to our west, west of 75, conditions are dry. So overall, good afternoon too to be out on the bike. Vipercast is showing that rain also fading, but really light. I mean, really light hit and miss stuff possible. I don't think we're going to get anything more measurable today. As we head into Friday, there's probably going to be more partly cloudy skies out there. I don't think we'll have abundant sun tomorrow, but that dew points, those will be dropping. So that's why, you know, if we had more moisture, I would put more of an overcast sky tomorrow. But Vipercast is just, it's just showing some high level clouds out there tomorrow. So tomorrow's going to be a nice one. Here's our afternoon planner today, putting us at a high of 82. We'll look for broken clouds this morning. We only fell to 70. So tonight I'm going to put us cooler down to the mid 60s. So tomorrow morning will be even nicer. Forecast highs tomorrow, 79 Chattanooga, 73 Altamont, 75 out of Murphy. And here's those dew points. Right now, they're in the upper 60s. But to our west and to our north, you can see where those dew points are a lot lower. Those dew points are going to come to our area by this weekend. So let's break down the Vipercast dew points. This is one forecast model. This is Friday night. It's showing dew points in the mid 60s. I think the Viper is actually going too high on those dew points at that point. I think they'll be dropping to the low 60s and upper 50s Friday night. And then Saturday morning, this is 8 a.m., 9 a.m., dew points will begin to flirt to the 50s and even low 40s, I think, in our northern counties. As we put this in motion all the way through Sunday, you can see a lot of dry air still in place. And then I think this forecast model is going to go out all the way through Monday. There we go. There's Monday morning at 8 a.m. So kiddos will need their jackets, not only in the higher elevations, but in the valley in Chattanooga on Monday morning. We also got the new drought monitor. This was released this morning. It shows abnormally dry conditions from Dayton and Chattanooga and over Fort Payne. So we're actually behind on rainfall and we could actually use it. However, take a look at the 7-day forecast. We don't have any rain chances in, but coming in the next half hour, we'll break down your high school football for Friday and your camping forecast for Friday night. Latrice, back to you.
All righty. Sounds like it's going to be a good weekend for football. Thank you so much there, Brittany.